They messed up my SpongeBob book.
How'd they mess up your SpongeBob book, Jeffy?
Look and see for yourself. Notice anything wrong with it?
They're not underwater?
No! SpongeBob has two tongues. He's got one down here and one up here licking his eyeball.
He does have two tongues.
That's so silly.
It's not silly, Mommy. This is serious business. This is a colossal fuck-up. This is officially licensed by SpongeBob SquarePants. You know how many people this had to go through before it hit the shelves? Someone's getting fired today unless they can confirm that SpongeBob actually does have two tongues, and then I'll get over it.
Jeffy, just calm down and read your book.
No, because I'm going to call Nickelodeon and fire somebody after I give them a piece of my mind.
There's someone at the door. Hello?
Hey, Marvin, I need your help.
What do you need help with, Goodman?
You're poor, right?
Yeah.
Well, I need you to teach me how to be poor.
Teach
you
how to be poor? Why?
Well, I just found out that I have another kid down in Mexico or some shit, and the mom's wanting me to pay her $5 million a month in child support. I didn't know Taco Bell was that expensive. I mean, I can afford it. I just don't want to. So what I did was, is I moved all my money to an offshore bank account, and then now I have to live off the least amount of money as possible for the next few months while the judge goes through my bank account, because I don't want him to see that I have a lot of money. So I need your help to teach me how to be poor.
Well, I mean, I'm really busy. I don't think I can do that right now.
I'll pay you $10,000.
I mean, sure, yeah. I can teach you how to be poor. So rule number one, don't give people money, because poor people can't afford to give people money.
Well, if I don't give you money, then how am I going to get you to do what I want you to do?
By being nice.
Ew, poor!
And the next rule is, come here. So another thing you can do to be more poor is not drive a Lamborghini.
Not drive a Lamborghini? What else am I supposed to drive? A bicycle? Ew!
No, no, you don't have to drive a bicycle. You can drive a car. You just need something more poor.
More poor? I know exactly what you mean. I'm gonna go buy one.
Okay. Where's Goodman at?
What the? All right, Marvin, I did what you said. I bought a poor car.
This is not a poor car. This is expensive.
It literally has the word poor in the name. It's a Porsche.
Well, it's still expensive, though.
Listen, Marvin, I can't go any lower than this. It's already shitty.
What? It's not a shitty car. This is really nice.
No, it is shitty. It's Porsche. It's Porsche. And it's offensive because it was named after George Bush on 9/11. It's a Porsche 911.
Oh, okay, fine. So you're saying this is the cheapest car you'll go?
Yeah, I can't do anything less than this, Marvin. It's shitty.
Okay, well, at least it's a start. You got rid of the Lamborghini. So let's go work on some other stuff.
All right.
Hey, baby, I need your help.
What's wrong, Goodman?
Well, Goodman paid us $10,000 to teach him how to be poor.
Wait, he spent $10,000 to learn how to be poor?
Yeah, I already told him that poor people can't hand out money.
Okay, good.
And I told him that poor people can't drive a Lamborghini.
Okay.
So what other things can we teach him to be poor?
Well, poor people don't walk around everywhere in a nice suit, so you're going to have to change your clothes.
You want me to get rid of my elephant asshole suit? 75 endangered African elephants were poached for their assholes to make this suit. This suit cost me $55 million. I take a bath in it, I sleep in it, I'm not getting rid of this.
Well, why don't you sell it if you need the money?
Sell it? I will never sell the suit. I will be buried in this suit.
Well, how about you just take it off? Because if the judge sees you walking around in a $55 million suit, he's going to make you pay child support.
You're right. So what am I supposed to wear to be poor?
All right, look, I'll pick out a poor outfit. Come on. All right, baby, I did that before. I'll get the old McDonald's belt
bomb. You look nice.
E-I-E-I, no, I don't. I look like a snowman. If a kid said, hey, Dad, does that man smell bad? He's going to say, yes, yes, he does. Stay away from him. He's stinky. My name's Mr. Goodman, not Mr. Goodwill.
Well, Goodwill, where we got this outfit from?
And it smells like the person who owned it before me shit my pants.
Well, it only cost $5.
Well, I would take $5 not to wear this.
Well, that's what we're going for, right?
I'm getting kind of hungry. I want a filet mignon. I think I'm going to have Chai to prepare my meal. Oh, Chai!
All right, sir. Here's your 8-ounce filet mignon with medium rind.
Are you sure it's 8 ounces? Because it looks more like 7.
I can assure you that it's 8, sir. I weigh the pig
on. We'll see about that. Sounds like 7.
No, sir. You couldn't make it. It doesn't mean 2.
But before I go, I must ask, why did you cross my mind? filet mignon?
No.
Holy stop! What am I supposed to eat then?
Well, I will go cook you a meal that horribly. Do not eat this, because if you want to look good for the judge, do not eat food like this. Hold on. All right, Goodman, I made you dinner.
Are you eating a steak?
No, it was a fly. There's no way a fly took that big a bite.
Yes, he did, you the big old bastard.
Listen, Goodman, here's your ramen noodles.
Instant lunch? Ew, poor, what is this?
It's called ramen noodles, and it's really cheap, but it's really good.
Who's ramen, and why do I have to eat his noodles?
Because it's really cheap, and it's really good. Try it.
And what is this? A Rice Krispie treat?
Well, no, that's what the noodles looks like before you cook it.
It looks like dried worms.
Guess you're right, Marvin.
Just go give me some water and let me clear my head. Voss water, sparkling, please.
No, poor people don't drink sparkling Voss water.
Fiji?
No.
Evian?
No, we drink water from the sink.
Right where the toilet is!
Or the kitchen sink?
It's all the same shit! It's pipes in the house! Ew, poor!
Listen, it's called tap water.
Whoa! I'm tapping out!
Well, listen, you gotta drink stuff like that if you want to be poor. What's other stuff they can do to save money?
Well, what do you spend most of your money on?
Well, my haircut costs $20,000.
But why would a haircut cost $20,000?
Because three naked girls cut my hair while giving me $100.
Well, we're not doing that anymore. Your haircut should only cost
$20. $20? They're gonna stab me in the eye with scissors or something.
That doesn't usually happen.
What else do you spend your money on?
Well, I did put a $250,000 down payment to go see the Titanic in a submarine, but that guy ain't called me back. I think he's ignored me.
Okay, look, you can't buy stupid stuff like that. And if you're gonna buy stuff, you have to go cheap.
Oh, I'm telling you not to take my big private jet, I gotta take my little one.
No, no private jets. Poor people don't have private jets.
Well, then how am I supposed to fly to Paris for lunch?
You're not gonna fly to Paris for lunch, and if you have to fly, you're gonna fly cheap. Let's steal airlines.
Cheap? I'm not gonna fly cheap, but I'm flying through the air.
Look, it's called Spirit Airlines, the nice airline.
What? What? Spirit Airlines? I'm gonna turn into a spirit!
Listen, it's just what you gotta do to be poor.
Wait, my phone's ringing. It's my son Richard's calling.
Hello?
Hey, man, me and my friends are down here in Orlando turning around a disco people, and they're telling me that costs $4 million. But my credit limit's only $3 million. So can you give me the other million?
My
son, he's in trouble. He's down in Orlando trying to rent out Disney World for the day, and they told him that it's gonna be $4 million, and his credit limit's only $3 million.
So do I give him the other million?
No!
You know what? No, you gotta tell him no, you're poor.
But I don't want him to yell at me.
You're poor, you're poor now. Tell him no.
Fuck. Richard, no. What the fuck, Dad? Yeah, I'm down here in Orlando with my friends trying to rent out Disney World, and you're gonna tell me no? When you want me to be poor? That's embarrassing. You want me to be embarrassed when I go back to school and be poor? Richard, no, you're not getting that other $1 million. I'll put my foot down. I put my foot down, not gonna give him that $1 million.
Say good, you told him no. What'd he say?
He said he was fine with it, that he understood.
Okay, I don't think you should have a $3 million credit limit. I think you should lower it to like $100.
I agree with that.
Okay, so look, we're saving money already. Okay, so let's go teach you how to call the police. What?
Poor
thing!
The dude's
Jeffy
already found the toilet!
That's good, so now you can learn. So look, sometimes you're taking a poop, they get stuck in the toilet, and you gotta push it down with the water.
Yeah,
what?
Okay.
You tell me to feel worse for poor people. So now when I see them on the side of the road, I'm just going to drive by them faster. Enjoy the $10,000. I'm done.
So, Marvin, what are we going to do with the $10,000?
I have no idea.
Hey, Daddy, I called Nickelodeon about this SpongeBob situation.
What'd they say about the two tongues?
They said one for the tooth and one for the stick.
What?
Yeah, they told me that if I wanted to change, then I have to pay the public.
So how much would that cost?
$10,000.
The real name, because we might get in trouble and end up on Good Morning America again.
No, Jeffy, I don't want to play any games.
Oh, come on, Marvin, it'll be fine.
Fine.
All right, Mommy, get the letter.
Is there an H?
Yep.
Yeah, I got it.
All right, Daddy, your turn.
Is there a C?
Yep.
Yes.
All right, Mommy.
Is there an I?
Yep.
All right, Dad. Is there a T?
Yep.
Oh, no.
It's spelled the same way with the B?
Boobies.
No! He's like, you know, big
boobies.
No! Baby, finish the word for me.
No!
No, Jeffy, you know, it sounds like beach.
B-boobies.
Jeffy, you ground it, take those two and pour me a really rough.
Before I go, Daddy, before I go, can I tell you something?
Tell me something. The people watching the video.
What?
Hold on, let me talk to you real quick.
Hey, guys, it's me, Jeffy.
Take our house.
A tornado?
What? No! Why would a tornado ring our doorbell?
Because it's a very dramatic tornado.
Oh my god, there's two of them now?
Yes, two tornadoes right here. Give me two. You like this house? Because we're going to be repossessing it soon.
It's not.
What happened to the house?
You haven't come out and made my house payment. Literally, you have to give me more time to make two house payments. You threw them on me today.
Yeah, that's fair. Goodman, too. How much time do you think we should give Marvin here to make both of his house payments?
2 days?
Well, if he can't afford a house payment, then he can't afford to leave the country.
Well, he can swim to Switzerland.
That would take longer than 2 days.
Shut up!
You know what, Marvin? God, I hate that. I'm going to give you until tomorrow morning to make both of your house payments, or else.
Well, tomorrow morning, I can't make that payment, or else what?
Or else this.
Hello, it is me, Dr. Rinderchief. Did you forget that I was in here? It's like I helped you with your phone. Can I go home now?
Shut up! So, Marvin, both of your house payments by tomorrow morning, or else I'm going to get Dr. Finkel sheets. Whatever. I'm going to get Dr. Finkel sheets to make a nipple enlarger ray to turn your nipples into big pepperonis. And then me and Mr. Goodman, too, are going to eat them. One nipple each.
Oh, okay, I'll get my mom.
Can I go home now?
Shut up! Tomorrow morning, or yummy your nipples.
Oh, yummy. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Marvin, where are you going to get two house payments by tomorrow?
I don't know. They're both $2,000 each, so we're made it $1,000 in one night.
Hey, Daddy, you want to play again?
This time I made it easy on you, and you only have to get
guys one letter.
Jeffy, stop writing bad words.
I didn't write bad words, Daddy.
Yeah, Jeffy, that's a bad word. I'm gonna get this bad. Yes, I give up. Right away.
Well, the word was.
No, it wasn't, Jeffy. You're trying to make it seem like it's a bad word. You made it not a bad word.
It was duck, Daddy.
Oh, I got to find it. Tomorrow, when Goodman shows up in the office, I'm just gonna get to the door.
Marvin, that's not gonna work.
Yeah, yes, it's gonna work because what's he gonna do? Break into my house? I'll call the cops. I'm not gonna answer the door tomorrow when Goodman shows up.
What a good day. Driving my Ferrari to go get Marvin's two house payments, or else I get to evict him.
Oh, you're not? Oh, no, him the wine, you need that.
That's because the front door jammed.
Then you can get a bunch of the front door down.
Yeah, sure, I'll do that. Right after I smash the kid's head with my hand.
You hear that? We're not gonna do it. We're not gonna do it. I'll tell you. Baby, I'm gonna show up the front door.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay, where is Goodman at? Yeah, where is he? Hold on! He's in the pantry! There he is! Kill him!
Marvin, you're helping him?
Yes, hit him with your mallet. Why do you smell like pepper?
Because I just want to smell some pepper, don't I?
No, the only reason we found you is because you sneezed.
Oh, no! Please don't let him hurt me, Marvin!
He says he'd give you $1 million, and he says he'll never own a house payment ever again.
I thought we were friends, Marvin!
No, we were never friends. You can hit him now. I want that $1 million.
Please, no!
Hit him harder.
I'm disappointed in you too, Marvin.
Wait, what? No, you're supposed to kill him to get that $1 million.
I can't believe that you would choose $1 million, a measly $1 million, over our friendship.
We're not friends!
Yeah, clearly. But this was all a setup, Mark.
What, a setup?
Yep, this is just some guy in a suit.
Some guy in a suit? Yeah, clearly it's a guy in a suit. It's your clone.
Take the mask off.
Look.
Oh, man, it is hot.
Yeah. It's still on your chin.
So, look at you in a suit?
Yeah, he paid me $10,000 to do this.
But what? Okay, you can explain what's going on.
Okay, so this is what happened. So I took out a $2 million insurance policy.
It was on $2.
You good?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I continue with my story?
Yeah, you explain what was going on.
Great. So I took out a $2 million policy, an insurance policy on my truck. Then when I wrecked it, I got paid $2 million. So what I did was I hired Dr. Fatal Fits to make a suit that looked just like me, and I paid him $10,000. Yeah.
Continue your story. So you wrecked your Ferrari for $2 million.
Yep. And then, like I said, I had Dr. Finkelfitz make a suit that looked just like me. I paid him $10,000 to get in it. And then, for fun, I decided to see if you would choose our friendship over $1 million.
Oh, come on. You'd kill me for $1 million.
I would.
So you just admitted that you get insurance fraud, and aren't you a cop arrested?
Well, I mean, he's gonna give me a cut, so I'll look the other way.
Well, I want some money.
Sure. I guess the best I can do is 2 months with no help. And what's that?
Wait, really? Two.
Bye bye. All three together now. Let's go. Bye bye.
Guys, I saw the coolest movie in the world last night, and I want to imitate it.
Do what was? Exactly.
Yeah, this old guy, he wants his house to fly, so he ties a bunch of balloons to his house, but his house actually flies, so I want my house to fly.
Look, you can't really do that, Junior. That was just a movie.
What? Yeah, I can. Balloons make stuff go in the air, so if I put enough balloons on my house, it'll go in the air.
Maybe, but it would take like millions of balloons.
So we're just gonna get millions of balloons.
Well, how are you gonna get millions of balloons? You buy it?
Yeah, what an idiot. He's so dummy. I don't even know what money is.
Dude, he's like only 2 cents for balloons.
Yeah, so it's like only $20.
Look, he's supposed to be the smart one.
I know.
Junior, just because you see something in a movie doesn't mean you can really do it.
It happened in a movie, Cody. Doesn't mean it can really happen. They don't make movies about something that doesn't happen.
Yes, they do. They do it all the time. What about Star Wars?
That actually happened. It happened a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. They didn't tell you in the beginning, Cody. It's history. So look, you're telling me that every Pixar movie didn't actually happen, so you're telling me that there's like Ratatouille. There's not a restaurant in France that's like ran by rats?
Yeah, no, that did not happen.
So rats, you don't come out of your closet and collect your screen? Yeah, but that happened.
But no, it doesn't.
Oh, yes, it does, Cody. Yes, it does. You and my homie goes out of my closet and collect my screens all the time. Exactly. Well, look, Cody, better think you come. Look, go to my closet. I bet you'll see the monster universe. You see my uncle? All right, guys. I'm about to open my closet. You ready to see a bunch of monsters trying to collect our screens so they can feed your family?
I gotta warn you guys first. My Uncle Larry, just like your pants, he's a goofball.
Guys, there's not gonna be anything in that closet
to close. Well, if my Uncle Larry's in that closet, there would not be any clothes.
Alright, look, guys, we're gonna open the door. I'm gonna see a bunch of monsters on the wall. Oh, wait, I forgot. They collect our laughs now. So, Cody, when we prove you wrong, we're all gonna laugh at you so we get my bunch of energy.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, say hi to Mike. What the
They
shredded our doors. They didn't want to.
and find out what the monster was.
I hate when that happens.
Well, Cody, why would you do this?
Whatever. Well, guys, I can't believe I've never seen Microsoft do something that reminds me of the monster in my door.
Yeah, Microsoft only came out with jokes. Anyway, back to what I was saying. I want to blow up a bunch of balloons so my house can fly. I want to go to space.
There's not enough balloons in the world to send your house to space.
We're gonna blow up some balloons and prove you wrong yet again.
Wait, again? You didn't prove me wrong about the monsters.
This is gonna take forever. Just hard to let you blow.
I'm being lightheaded.
Me too.
You know, if you think that works, you don't have to have balloons.
What are you talking about?
You need helium balloons.
You need a rubber balloon.
No, Junior, helium is what goes inside the balloons. It's a gas.
Oh, Joseph, we're supposed to be farting in the balloons. Start farting in them.
Oh, I can do that. Yeah, totally sucks.
It sucks.
Come on, why would I do that?
Guys, I think
we should skip, because we don't really have any, like, you know, proof. So I think we should skip this round and just see if we have any, like, evidence that we
guess so, dude. Let's skip.
All right, you get away with this one.
Okay, good. Now, I'm going to just walk around the house and try to find some more clues.
Who could the imposter be?
Oh, my 100 cheesecake tonight! My old room has been delicious! Oh, who am I kidding? Of course I can! Come here, you! Oh, hey there, Bucky! What are you doing with that knife?
Would you like a piece of cheesecake?
Oh!
Couch.
Oh, well, I was doing my job in the kitchen.
You were in the kitchen, you. Oh, I was cooking in the kitchen.
What were you cooking?
Pasta?
Pasta.
Imposter. Well, it's not me. You guys gotta be kidding. Look, I am not the imposter. I heard someone say, hey, donkey, a minute ago.
Oh, tell me what he calls donkey.
Okay.
It's either Chevy D or the cop. Chevy D or the cop. Push for the coin, head to jail.
Your eyes.
Fries that'll tie your tie.
Fries that'll stop your cries.
Fries that'll keep you from being shy.
Shy?
Oh, really, guys? Is this what we're gonna do for 8 hours? Just make fry rhymes?
Okay, we love it for I Spy. I Spy with my little eye. He's wearing glasses, he's a dork, he's ugly.
Okay, you know what? I didn't even want to come.
You're right, it was you!
Okay, fine. You know what? I have one. I Spy with my little eye. A colossal waste of my time.
Your life?
No, no, don't. Okay, I have another one. I Spy. Two idiots were wasting just to wait for French fries.
Oh, that's
always good.
Yeah, that's right, you win.
Okay, Joseph, stand up here.
Why, dude?
I want to be first.
Oh, no, 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 I want to be first.
No, 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 I was my kids, I want to be first.
No, I was first, first.
No, 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 I want to be first.
No, you can't
get it by
yet
where you belong.
Wait, what do you mean by that, dude?
No, 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 my idea, so you got to be right there.
No, no, you might always think you're better than us.
No, no, it's fine. You can't even watch my fries.
You know what? Screw your fries. I'm out of here, too.
Oh, good, Leo, I will show you anyway.
Not you. Dare try to skip me.
I'm not gonna skip you, I don't care.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Don't you try it.
I'm not gonna try it.
I have to hide you.
I don't care.
How much longer do you have to wait?
About 8 hours.
Damn.
Yeah, damn, I know.
8 hours?
Yeah.
I'm starting to get tired.
You wanna go home?
No, we need to be first in line. Get the fries. I'm not yawning, I'm just... Oh, my phone's ringing.
I don't care.
It's on silent.
Then how did you hear?
Hold on, Cody. Chef Pee Pee's calling me. I have to answer it. It might be an emergency. Hello? Chef Pee Pee? Yeah, it's me, Junior. What's wrong? You sounded sick. What? Why are you yelling? Do you need me to go home right now? But I'm at the McDonald's waiting in line with Cody. Really? Right now? Okay, let me tell Cody.
Jesus, I hope you have apple care.
Look, Cody, I have to go home right now.
But why?
Because Chef Pee Pee needs me to clean the entire kitchen because I spill apple juice everywhere.
Junior, if you're leaving, I'm leaving.
No, 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 you have to hold our spot in line. So I'm like, take it.
Junior, no one's going to take it. Look around. There's no one for miles.
Well, there might be a guy in the bush over there. And as soon as we leave our spot, he's going to take our spot in line. And then he can get all the free French fries.
Junior, I'm pretty sure nobody else even knows about this damn French fry deal.
Look, look, just take it. Just wait right here for 5 minutes. If I'm not back in 5 minutes, you can leave.
Really?
No, no, no. I need you to wait the whole time. But look, just give me an hour or two.
What, an hour or two? Jesus, Junior, did you sell a whole orchard's worth of apple juice?
What's an orchard?
It's where they grow apples.
What?
Wait, yeah, that's where. But look, just make it quick, okay?
Please, just wait right here. Do not leave. Don't leave the spot in line. I'll be right back, okay? Just wait right here. Don't leave no matter what. Even if someone's trying to take the spot, don't leave.
Hurry up. My Junior, it's been hours. Come on, Junior, answer. Junior. Junior, wait, what are you doing? Yes, where are you?
Is it French fry time?
What? No, it's not French fry time.
Where are you from?
But because I don't know where you are, you were supposed to be back hours ago.
I'm still cleaning the orange juice.
Wait a minute. Earlier you said it was apple juice.
Huh?
When you said you had a mess to clean, you said it was apple juice.
Oh, yeah. Well,
what?
Yeah, it was apple juice, orange juice, grape juice. It was a whole bunch of fruit juices.
What, Cody, what do you want from me? Where are you?
I'm cleaning up the mess.
Well, hurry up and come back.
Okay, give me a few minutes to get up from the ground because I've been wiping up the juices so much with napkins. Hold on, speaking of napkins. Yeah, baby, get me more napkins.
Maybe that's the worst Chef Pee Pee impression I've ever heard.
What are you talking about, Chef Pee Pee? Look, Cody, listen. Let me just get up. Okay. I'm tired from cleaning, and I took a quick nap on the floor.
A nap?
I'm on my way. I'm on my way. Do not leave the spot. Okay, I'm on my way right now. Okay, running.
You don't sound like you're running.
Not bad.
Junior, I'm in the car. You're not in the car.
I'm going through a tunnel.
There are no tunnels on the way here. Junior.
Hey, Cody, how you feeling?
I think I'm dying.
Man, I had the best sleep of my life. My night.
Yeah, I bet you did.
What's wrong with you?
I've been standing here for 12 hours, Junior. I've been exhausted.
No one tried to skip you, right?
No, no one else cares. No one else is even in line. Can you please just take my spot so I can go home?
No, I really have to go pee.
Well, why didn't you just go to your house?
Because I have to go then. Look, I'm gonna go pee in that bush over there.
Well, why can't you just wait for them to open so you can use their bathroom?
When are they gonna open?
Any minute now.
Look, I'm gonna go pee in the bush. Just wait right here. You've been waiting all night. You can wait one more second.
Just hurry up.
Congratulations, boy. You're the first one at McDonald's.
No, actually, my friend Junior over there peeing in the bush, he was actually first.
Well, you're the only one here, but you get free French fries for a year!
No, Junior was actually first.
Well, get a picture with me, boy! Come here! This boy loves his McDonald's!
I don't actually like McDonald's.
Well, Cody, you thought about
French fries
for a year!
No, Junior, I'm trying to tell him that
you're— What do you mean? You stinky scurvy! So you can get the French fries! You knew how much
nothing's meant to me.
Well, Junior, I don't even want your damn french fries.
What up, fucking mustache?
Well, Junior, come on. Well, boy, how does it feel to get all those french fries? Well, you know what? It actually feels pretty good. I want the fries now.
God, I hate Cody so much. Some friend.
Junior, you're being ridiculous.
Cody, go away.
Why? Because I waited 12 hours in line for you to get your stupid fries?
No, because you took my spot so you could be the first customer.
I didn't take your spot. You had to use the bathroom.
You made me have to use the bathroom.
What? How?
You put some weird voodoo witchcraft spell on my blood that made me have to go pee at bad times.
Wait, Junior, do you even hear yourself? You sound insane.
Cody, you took my spot. You took my french fries.
Look, I don't even want the fries. Take the stupid car.
No, I didn't own them.
Yeah, we all know that. I'm the one who waited 12 hours in line.
You took that back.
What are you talking about? That's just a fact. Fries, and I'll see you guys next week with my next free medium fry.
I hate Cody so much. Okay, Joseph, what Lego set should we build now?
I'm not sure. Hey, Dad. Whoa, that's weird.
Cody, what Lego set should we build?
No, really, I'm really gonna do that. Every single week, I'm gonna have a box of fries with you. And if you don't see me with a box of fries at least once a week, then you can yell and scream in the comments and be mad at me. But I'm gonna do it. I'm really gonna do it.
Yeah, we'll see, Cody.
All right, class. So for your homework this weekend, you have to write a 1,000-word essay on why the sky is blue. You turn it in Monday. And if you don't, you fail.
A 1,000-word essay? That's gonna take forever.
Can you make it 2,000 words?
Too, so come around, you're done.
Get wrecked, noobs.
Hey, Jenny.
What's up, dude? Hey, guys. I haven't seen you all weekend. What were you doing?
Oh, we just finished writing our essay.
Yeah, it took forever.
It really took that long?
Oh, yeah. It took all night Friday and all day Saturday night.
That's crazy.
Did you write your essay?
Not yet.
Wait, what do you mean you didn't write your essay?
I've been playing Fortnite. They got rid of building.
Well, you're gonna fail.
I'm not gonna fail. I was gonna write my essay tonight.
Well, Jenny, you can't.
Oh, no, I can ride tonight. Just trust me, guys. Don't worry about me.
Well, if you're gonna ride the hurdle, man, you can ride the hurdle with us.
I wanna ride the hurdle.
You can throw up 6 times for 1 time.
Oh, I'm
totally going.
I'm going with you guys.
What about your essay?
I guess you're right. I guess I should be responsible and stay home and write my essay.
Joseph, we're gonna leave now. We wanna make the movie.
Oh, dude, I totally forgot!
What movie?
We're gonna go see the new Batman.
What? I don't wanna go see the new Batman!
But you can't, Junior. It's 3 hours long. You don't have time.
Well, I have time, God. How about I write my essay after the movie?
Junior, you're not gonna have time.
Yeah, you're pushing it, bro. Guys, let me worry about my problems. I wanna go see the new Batman. I'll call it a fake job.
Wait to watch this movie. Yeah, me too.
Cody, I can't believe you spent $50 on popcorn.
Oh, I know. The prices at movie theaters are insane. I wanted something salty in my mouth, and Ken's not here.
Well, guess what, guys? I snuck in snacks.
What, Junior, you snuck in snacks? That's illegal.
Dude, you could go to jail for like 5 years for that.
Well, guys, no one's gonna notice. Look, let's just watch the movie. Thank God this movie's over.
Jesus, that movie was way too long.
I'm more of a Spider-Man guy myself.
And guess what, guys? I didn't get caught with my snacks.
Hey, those snacks we don't sell here.
Officer, you do sell the snacks here.
No, I know what snacks we sell, and they're very expensive.
You're going to jail for sneaking in snacks. I'm so sorry.
Welcome to Poobie's courtroom, where you're always guilty till proven innocent.
What are you guys in here for?
So what you in here for?
I snuck snacks into a movie theater.
Or sneaking in snacks. Oh yeah, you have some visitors.
Visitors?
Junior?
Look, guys, you have to get me out of here. Otherwise, I gotta say,
not looking too good, Jewel.
You're facing 5 meters. I told you not to sneak in those snacks.
Go, please bail me out.
Your family just cost a large popcorn in your drink.
That's like $250. Oh, you bailed me out.
Junior, that's
What am I gonna do for a few hours?
Look back away from me! I just want to do Batman movie and I know all his moves.
I just want to be your friend.
I am vengeance!
All right, you monster, you somehow made bail.
I did?
Yeah, but you're banned from every movie theater, so I hope it was worth it.
Well, just let me out of here.
Thanks for bailing me out, Cody.
You owe me $250.
All right, guys, I have to focus. I have to write this essay.
Well, you better hurry, because it's already 9 p.m., and you have to have the essay done before school tomorrow morning.
Look, nothing else is going to distract me. All I'm going to do is this essay.
Better do it. Oh, my mom texted me.
I didn't know elephants could use a phone.
Oh, my God, guys. She ran out of peanuts?
She lost weight?
No, my Lego Titanic set came in.
What, Lego Titanic?
Yeah, it's a Lego replica of the Titanic.
But that's so cool.
Let's go build it downstairs, Joseph. We don't want to distract Junior.
Okay, dude.
What about you guys? I want to help build it.
No, Junior, you have to write your essay.
I'll write it as soon as we get done doing this.
No, Junior, this is going to take hours to build.
Not if all three of us work on it. It won't take that long.
No, you're going to fail.
Did the Titanic fail?
Yes.
Well, I'm not the Titanic. I'm not going to fail. I'm not going to run through an iceberg. Guys, I'm going to help build this. Come on, let's go downstairs.
All right, guys, look at all these pieces.
Dude, there's so many pieces. How many do you think there are?
There's 9,090.
Wait, you counted them already?
No, it says it right on the box.
Oh! Oh man, I thought you were one of those nerds. I mean, you are, but...
Yeah, Cody, you are a nerd.
Okay, guys, what I think we should do is I'll build this part, you build that part, and Joseph can build that part.
Okay, dude, I'm about to get on.
Yeah, I'll build my part.
Junior, I really think we should start writing your essay.
I really think you're mocking me.
Okay, fine. Just don't say anything more,
okay, let's build.
Here is your 2001 SML Movies.
teach them.
What? How are you gonna pay me?
You should stop charging for the show because I'm smart.
So happy that I got it done.
Wait, where's Penelope?
She's to the school. She called me and said her boyfriend broke up with her. Yeah, where's the teacher?
Julia, Johnson, Cody, what are you doing here? It's spring break. You're not supposed to come to school until next Monday.
Spring break?
Oh, we had a whole week to write this essay. In that case, you should have just given us four down.
Massage appointment, and he told me to stay in my room because I was grounded because I ran up $100,000 on the credit card and I'm buying V-Bucks for Fortnite. So I'm in my room, and I'm like, what would be a good idea? I'm gonna go joyriding in my dad's brand new car. And I wrecked it, Junior. I ran into a tree. You ran to a tree? Yeah, and I need you to come look at the damage and tell me if you think my dad's gonna notice.
Okay.
Alright, Junior. I'm not even gonna show you where the dent is. I just wanna see if you notice.
Okay.
Damn it!
Yeah, I know it's good.
Well, the only thing that I got going for me right now is that my dad is old, so maybe his eyesight isn't as good as ours.
Yeah, we're young, so I probably notice it.
Oh, darn it, I just remembered my dad got LASIK twice.
Why do you have twice?
Well, the first time he got it, he was dating his wife, and he thought that she was ugly, so he thought his eyes were bad, so he went and got LASIK. So then, he still thought that his wife was ugly, so he got LASIK again. Realized that she was just ugly, and so he divorced her, so she ended up being my mom.
BMW
stands for Big Mexican Women, which is what I'm trying to pick up with my BMW here, and take it back to my mom's family. You know, I like my women how I like my tacos, fully salad.
Well, how'd you get a tree?
Well, let me tell you, Junior, I was driving along, picture this, driving along, clear road, and all of a sudden, boom, tree.
The tree ran off?
Yeah, and so I think we should file a police report saying that it was a hit and run because the tree ran off and I didn't even get his insurance information.
That's a good idea because if it's a tree fall, then your dad will get mad at you.
Exactly.
Let's call the police.
Hey, big Mexican women.
Right?
Nice. All right, why'd you call me?
So there's a dent on my car, and I'm not going to show you where it is. I just want to see if you notice it.
Well, yeah, I can see it right there.
Damn it! That noticeable.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious.
Did you get lazy recently?
No, we got a big old dent. What happened?
Picture this. I was driving my dad's car, and all of a sudden, a tree jumped out in the middle of the road, and I hit it, and then he ran off, and I didn't collect his insurance. It was him. Let's go arrest him. He did.
Well, he's not actually on the planet as far as I know, so I don't think that was him. But, you know, I am a mechanic, so I can probably take care of it for you.
Okay, that'd be great.
All right, let me go get my overalls off.
You can probably fix it.
Yeah. All right, I'm back.
Is that a toilet plunger?
No, this is the Suck-O-Matic 5000. It has 5,000 pounds of suck-it. You think it'd suck anything. At least my wife for that thing would talk less.
Well, can I get the dent out?
Oh, can it get the dent out? Of course we'll get the dent out. Almost good as new. Check this out.
Say that somebody hit your car with a hammer.
But I'm not supposed to be over here, Junior, because my dad grounded me and I'm supposed to be in my room.
Cody.
You call that?
Yes, child. Look what you did to my dad's car. Bad child. Bad. I'm gonna rub your nose in. You've been a bad child.
But I didn't do this, sir.
Well, that's what we're gonna tell my dad.
But you didn't be in your room with your family.
And shouldn't you be washing dishes or doing whatever bumpers do?
I was. I'm very cold, sir.
Well, child, we're gonna call my dad and tell him that you wrecked his car. This is the story, Chives. You drug me out of my room, even though I was grounded, and you promised me to take me to McDonald's. You slammed this car into a tree because you're a drunk. And in the McDonald's drive-thru, some crazy maniac came up with a hammer and started hitting the car.
What would I get for killing your father, then, sir?
You get to keep your job.
But wouldn't I lose my job when your father found out what I did to your car?
No, he's just gonna give you a spanking like he always does. So come inside, we're gonna call my dad.
All right, John, call my dad. Do it up for the man, sir.
Do it!
Nothing can ruin this day.
Unbelievable.
Ow, my eye.
What? Who's at the door?
Go check and see if it's my dad.
Okay. Yeah, your dad's here. What do we do?
Go answer the door and try to stall. See if he notices the dent.
Okay. Hello?
Where are they?
Well, they're upstairs, but we want to go look at the car real quick. I gotta ask you something. All right, so Richard doesn't want me to show you where the dent is. He wants to see if you can see it with your own eyes. So on the count of three, I want you to point out the damage. One, two, three.
Right here. All of this. Oh, and don't forget, down here too.
What? We didn't even notice that.
Yeah, well, good thing I got LASIK twice.
Oh, well, okay, you can come inside now. All right, here they are.
All right, Chives. Now, was everything that you told me on the phone true? Now, think about it, Chives, because if you lie to me, then I'm going to pack you up in a little crate and ship you to Madagascar, where you're going to be dancing with little lemurs to the song, I Like to Move It, Move It. Now, tell me, Chives, do you like to move it, move it?
No, sir.
So what happened?
Oh, no, I'm having a heart attack.
Don't you pull that fake heart attack crap with me, Chives. You tried doing that last week. So what happened? Dad, everything he told you is true. Okay, and you're going to stick with that? Yep. Now let me tell you, I do have a dash cam. It's a little camera on the windshield that records everything. So does anyone want to change their story?
I think you should tell him the truth.
Okay, Junior. All right, Dad, listen, this is what happened. So I was sitting in my room, grounded, like you told me I was, and Chives came in with the BMW key, and he threw it at me and said, hey, you should go joyriding while your dad's getting a massage. And I was like, but I'm grounded. But Chives insisted, Dad. So I was driving along, and I hit a tree.
And then I brought it straight back to Junior's house to try to fix it so I wouldn't get in trouble for what Chives told me to do. And that's when this crazy guy came and hit the car with a hammer. And you'll see that on your dash cam.
I thought he'd actually tell the truth.
That is it, Chives! Get ready for your spankings!
Shall I get the paddle, sir?
Actually, I think I'm gonna use my lucky tennis racket.
Very good, sir.
But Chives, you didn't do anything.
That's okay, this is just my life.
No, I'm not gonna sit back and let this happen. Mr. Goodman, sir, Richard's lying.
What are you doing, Junior?
I'm telling the truth for you. So Chives didn't do anything, so Chives didn't get any spankings. Richard lied, and Richard deserves the spankings.
Richard, is this true? Oh, yeah, Dad. I can't believe you, Richard! Chives, get the paddle!
Very good, sir.
I'm gonna teach your little hiney a lesson.
Jeffy, it's time for bed!
Daddy, can I send it one more time before bed?
Jeffy, what is this thing?
Well, there's a little car in here, and when I hit this thing, it goes around the doodah.
Then just do it real quick.
All right.
Ow, Jeffy, you hit me with the car!
Can I do it one more time?
No, Jeffy, it's time to go to bed. Come on.
Let's do all the things you want to do.
Okay, Jeffy, just lay down and go to sleep.
But I want fried okra.
Wait, what, Jeffy? No, it's too late. You're not getting fried okra.
I want it fried.
You're not getting it, Jeffy.
In my mouth.
Jeffy, just go to sleep. I don't want to hear a peep out of you.
Beep. Beep, beep.
Jeffy, shut up. Wait, Jeffy, did you shoot me with a Nerf gun?
No.
Wait, Jeffy, what is that?
Fried okra.
Where'd you get fried okra?
The fried okra tree.
Jeffy, why don't you just eat that fried okra?
Because that's yesterday's fried okra. You can't expect me to eat day-old okra.
But Jeffy, I don't know what's going on. Just go to sleep, please.
Aww.
All right, Jeffy, good night. This door is so squeaky. Jeffy?
I want fried okra.
No, Jeffy, you have fried okra in your bed. Go to sleep. That door is so squeaky. I have to get that fixed soon. I just want to lay down and watch TV. Jeffy's dumb toys on the couch. I'm going to play with it. It's broken. It's dumb. Jeffy, your dumb toy's broken. Jeffy, close the door.
Okra.
No, Jeffy, you're not eating okra.
Okra.
It's too late for okra. Close the door.
Okra.
Close it. Jeffy, I said close the door. Thank you. Stop it! Stop, Jeffy! It's so annoying! I'm getting a fix! I'm calling somebody to fix it!
Hey there, somebody call a handyman? I can do literally anything except give handies. So I guess I'm a not handyman. But I can fix things, so what do you need?
Well, my son's door
is... Oh, is this Hot Wheels? Oh, that's so sick. Hey, do you mind if I send it?
Sure.
Oh, so close! Oh, man, that was cool. Hey, do you mind if I try again?
Okay, fine, but, like, yeah, listen to what's wrong. So, my son has this door that's really squeaky.
I'm listening.
My son has this door that's really squeaky.
Oh, right there, every time! Okay, I'm trying again.
Oh, no, but my son's door is really squeaky, and I want you to fix it, and you're not even listening.
Oh, okay, this thing sucks. What were you saying?
So my son has this door, it's really squeaky, and I was wondering if you'd fix it.
Oh, squeaky door? Yeah, that's easy, I can do that. Just show me.
Okay, it's over here. All right, here's the door. Listen.
Hey, you know what that sounds like? My bed springs in college! Huh? Yeah? Because I was doing a lot of this, you know? Yeah, I'm just kidding, I didn't actually have a girlfriend. But you know, good for the people who can get hoes.
Can you please fix my door?
Oh yeah, it's an easy fix. I just gotta use some of this WD-40.
What's WD-40?
You don't know what WD-40 is? Pff, what an idiot! Everybody knows what WD-40 does. It stops squeaks, removes and protects, loosens rusted parts, frees sticky mechanisms, drives out moisture, and is fatal if swallowed. Nah, I'm just kidding. But can you imagine, though? Just, and that's it. I'm gone. Dead. That's it. No more me.
Can you please fix the door?
Yeah, sure. You weren't gonna stop me? Yeah, some friend.
No, I just want you to fix my door.
No. You act like you're gonna do it.
Well, no, I don't want to do
it. No, act like you're gonna do it. No, don't do that. Don't you know that's fatal if swallowed? You're gonna die. Hey, man, I care about you. I don't want you to do something like that. See, that's what you should have done.
Oh, look, I just want you to fix my door. I know you're not gonna do it.
Okay, fine. Okay, I put a crap ton on there. Now let's see if the door squeaks. What the hell? It's still squeaking. Okay, fine. I'll just put more on there. And you know what? I'll do all the hinges. Except for that one. That one's too high up. That one's higher than my ex-wife during the custody hearing. I mean, she still got custody of the kids because I had two DUIs. But let's see if the door squeaks. What? Oh, okay, what's going on here? Does this stuff not work? I bet it's not even fatal if swallowed. What, really? You weren't gonna stop me again after all that? You know what? You're a bad friend. You deserve to have a squeaky door.
I just want you to fix my door, please.
Okay, fine. Give me some peanut butter.
Peanut butter?
Who's the handyman here, me or you? Go get the peanut butter.
Okay. Why are you putting peanut butter on my door?
Because it's gonna muffle the squeak because it's so thick. Just like my ex-wife. You know, she was thick, fat. All right, whenever I close the door, you're not gonna hear the squeak anymore. What is that? What is that crunching noise? What? Oh, no, you didn't.
What?
You got extra crunchy peanut butter?
Yeah, I like it.
What are you, sick in the head? Who the hell uses extra crunchy peanut butter?
I do.
What, do you put glass in your cake?
What?
Do you eat eggs with the shell still on them?
No.
Well, it's the same thing.
Well, I just like extra crunchy peanut butter.
Do you have creamy peanut butter?
No, just that.
Well, see, that's the problem. You use crunchy peanut butter, so now we got a crunch and a squeak. You just added a crunch to the squeak.
Oh, can you just fix my door?
Go get me a belt.
A belt?
Yeah, because the door's making a noise, and when I was a kid and I was making noises, my mom would beat me with a belt, and that sure shut me the hell up.
A belt's not gonna work with a door.
Go get the belt!
Ugh. Okay, here's your belt.
Oh, that's a good one. That looks like it's gonna hurt. Okay, hold on, let me get into character. Brookie, get your ass in here!
Yes, Mommy?
Brookie, let me see your report card!
Have you been drinking, Mommy?
Shut up and let me see your report card! What's this? All C's again! No son of mine's gonna be this average! You think I like doing this? Well, I do! It hurts you so much more than it hurts me, and I love it! Okay, this door's definitely not gonna squeak after that. Oh, you want some more, do you?
No, stop, it's not gonna work.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Oh, man. I've never seen a door this squeaky in my whole life.
Well, can you fix it or not?
Hey, do you think there's more doors in the world or wheels?
What?
Like, in the whole world, do you think there's more doors or wheels?
I don't know.
Well, like, if you think about a car, there's, like, four doors, but there's also four wheels. So, I mean, I guess it kind of evens out there. But if you think about an 18-wheeler, there's so many more wheels than there are doors. Oh, and, like, in skyscrapers, like, there's a whole bunch of doors, but, like, no wheels. I mean, I guess there's wheels in the elevators. But then there's also doors, too!
Well, in a car, there's also a steering wheel.
Oh, my God, you're right. They got, like, five wheels. Oh, okay, so how many cars are there in the whole world?
I don't know.
Well, Google it.
No!
Okay, fine. I'll Google it. How many cars are there in the world? What? There's 1.4 billion cars! Wow, okay, so you multiply that by five, that's like almost 6 billion wheels!
Man, that's crazy.
That's a lot of wheels. Oh my God. You know what else has wheels? Trains? Trains have wheels and trucks and buses and not boats. Oh, they have a steering wheel! Oh my God, I gotta Google so many things.
Oh, no. Can you please just fix my door or not?
Listen, man, I think only God could fix this door. That's it! We can ask God to fix the door!
God is too busy to fix my stupid door.
Well, it's worth a shot. God, please fix this door.
Hey guys, what's up?
God, I'm sorry for bothering you.
Oh, not at all. I was just in my room looking at TikTok. You know, I've been alive forever. That's a really long time, so I'm pretty bored by this point. You know, I used to watch dinosaurs fight and kill each other. Now I just watch people lip sync and dance. What happened? I'm gonna send a meteor and reset this whole mess. So what's up?
See, my door's really squeaky.
Hey, God, are there more doors in the world or wheels?
Oh, that's a really good question. It's actually wheels, but it's close.
I knew it!
Well, God, so my door's really squeaky.
No, sorry, that's all the time I had. I gotta go meet Poseidon at Cracker Barrel. Ugh. You know those little peg games they have on the tables? I've never been able to figure those out. All these years, I've never been able to do it. Anyway, I'll see you guys later.
Oh, great. Not even God was able to fix my door.
Yeah, sorry, I'm just really obsessed about this whole doors and wheels thing. Glad I got my answer, though.
Are you able to fix my door or not?
No, man, I don't think I can do it. This door's a lost cause.
I knew it. I knew you couldn't do it.
What, excuse me?
I knew you weren't good enough to fix my door.
What? Hey, I'm pretty good.
No, if you were good, you'd fix my door by now. I'm gonna go hire a real handyman.
What? Oh, okay, you want your door fixed? All right, fine, I'll fix your door.
What are you doing?
I'm fixing it!
What are you doing?
I'm fixing your door!
No, you just broke my door!
Oh, that was just part of the plan. I was gonna break the door so that I could buy you a new door that doesn't squeak.
What? Oh, you gonna go get me a new door?
Yeah, I'll go get it right now.
Oh my God.
Here you go. Here's your new door.
It looks just like the old one, except it doesn't have a big hole in the middle.
Yep, and this one doesn't squeak. I guarantee it.
Well, then install it!
Alright, here we go. Alright, the new door's installed.
But does it squeak?
Let's find out. Oh, please. I hear that? No squeak!
Oh, you did it!
Yes, I am so good. Why am I so good?
Well, where'd you get the door from?
Oh, I took it off my daughter's bedroom. She doesn't need it. You know, she's getting older. She might start having boys over. So anything she does in there, she's gonna have to do with no door.
Well, how much do I owe you?
$100.
$100?
Yeah, man, I did a lot today. I had to steal my daughter's door. I had to relive childhood trauma. I did a lot.
Okay, let me grab my wallet.
Okay.
All right, here's your $100.
Thank you. I think I'm gonna use this to buy a Hot Wheels set like this one. It's so cool. Oh my god, I didn't even think about all the wheels on toy cars. They got like 4 wheels and no doors.
Oh my god.
How many Hot Wheels cars do you think there are in the world?
I don't know.
I'm gonna Google it. How many Hot Wheels cars in Oh my god, there's like 4 billion Hot Wheels cars. And it says if you lay them all end to end, it'll circle the entire globe 4 times. So there's 4 billion cars. That's like 16 billion wheels. No wonder the wheels are winning.
That's so crazy.
Oh, I didn't even think about Lego wheels. Oh, the wheels are just piling up.
Ugh. Hey, Danny, why'd you replace my door?
Because it wouldn't stop squeaking, Jeffy.
Oh, you mean this noise?
What? Jeffy, it was you making the noise?
Maybe.
Wait, Jeffy, so we'd have to replace the door?
Maybe.
Wait, Jeffy, why would you do that?
Because I wanted fried okra.
Oh, that sounds so good. Hey, you want to go to Cracker Barrel? I heard God's going to be there.
Oh, my God. Leave. Both of you guys leave. Roar! Jeffy, what are you doing?
I'm in my lion costume, Daddy.
A lion doesn't go blah, 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 blah.
Well, this one does.
Jeffy, look, take your costume off. It's not Halloween.
No, Daddy, I just want you to put it on to make sure it was scary. Roar! Is it scary?
No, it's not scary, Jeffy.
Well, I bet if I ate someone's face off, it'd be scary.
Jeffy!
You're not Jeffrey Dahmer. You're a lion.
Well, my name's Jeffy.
Look, just go outside, Jeffy.
All right, Daddy. Roar!
Whee! I'm playing at the playground with my pencil, no shoes, and my pants are down. This is a good day. Whee! Oh, Jesus Christ, it's a lion! Oh, no! Oh, no!
So, baby.
Yeah, Marvin?
Jeffy's outside, and we're all alone.
Oh!
So I was thinking maybe I can give you a full body massage.
Okay, Marvin, I see where this is going.
See what it leads to. No, the news is on. So watch the news.
Breaking news, MK. A lion has escaped from the local zoo and attacked a child at a park. We have an exclusive interview with the child now. Let's go to that.
So I was at the park with my favorite pencil that I always bring with me to the park, and then suddenly a lion attacked me and I stabbed him in the nose.
Wow, truly terrifying. If you've seen this lion, please call 911 immediately. There's a $10,000 reward for anyone who finds him.
Morgan, there's a lion on the loose and Jeffy's outside! You have to go get him!
Okay, I'll go get him. Oh, thank God, Jeffy, there you are. You have to go inside right now. There's a lion on the loose. Don't you yell at me, Jeffy. Get inside. Jeffy, knock it off.
Oh, good, Marvin. You found Jeffy.
Yeah, but he won't stop acting like a lion.
Wow, Jeffy, your roar's gotten really good.
Jeffy, just go to your room. Poor Jeffy!
What did he do, Marvin?
He clawed open the couch!
Jeffy, you're not a real lion. You can't do that.
Yeah, Jeffy, go cut your fingernails.
Why?
Oh, it's gonna cost so much money to fix the couch.
All right, world, hear me roar. Roar! Oh, hey, what's going on?
Gotcha, you little bastard. Don't worry, everybody. I caught the lion.
Where are you taking me?
What, a talking lion? No. I think I still have some of those brownies in my system. Come on, let's go put you down.
Oh, baby, yeah. Oh, I love the way that feels. Oh, I'm almost there. Oh.
Hey, Shaggy B, what are you doing?
Junior, I'm beating my meat. Oh, leave me alone. Let me beat it in peace.
I can help.
Cody, I know how to beat my meat by myself, okay? Leave me alone.
I can use my mouth.
Just get out of here. Get out of this brand, you little brats. God. What happened to my meat? Who took my meat? Junior! What did you guys do with my meat?
We didn't do anything with it. You wouldn't let me help.
Look, I was beating my meat, then you guys came in there and bothered me. Now it's gone.
Well, I'm sorry for interrupting, but I can help you get it back up.
Yeah, help me get it back.
All right, whip it out.
No, not that. I'm talking about a steak.
Steak? What steak?
Oh, my God. God, Cody. Marvin!
What's wrong, Chef Pee Pee?
Have you guys seen my meat?
What?
Seen your meat?
Yes, it's big and floppy. I was just beating it in the kitchen.
What? Well, no, we haven't seen your meat.
Come on now. Somebody seen it because somebody grabbed it. Now tell me who grabbed it.
I didn't grab your meat.
Did you grab it?
No, I didn't grab your meat.
I know you grabbed it. You look like you grabbed me. Come on now.
No, I did not grab your meat.
Baby, you grabbed his meat.
Marvin, I didn't grab his meat.
Now, I wouldn't blame you if you wanted a taste of it.
What? No, we didn't taste it.
Look, tell me who grabbed it and I'll give you a taste of it. I promise.
Well, no. I'm going to call the cops. You're being perverted, Chef Pee Pee.
What? Being perverted? I'm just talking about my steak.
Wait, steak?
Yes! Wait, look, he has it!
What, Jeffy, you ate Jeffy B's steak? Give it back!
Get my meat out your mouth!
Give it up to me. Sorry, Chef Pee Pee.
Yeah, that's my meat! Don't touch my meat no more!
Jeffy, you know what? You're grounded for taking Chef Pee Pee's meat. Come on!
Yeah!
All right, Jeffy, lay down and go to sleep. It's past your bedtime anyway. Hey, you better calm down. You're lucky I'm letting you wear your lion costume to bed.
Bye.
Go to sleep.
So, Marvin, did you get Jeffy to bed?
Yeah, but he was fighting it.
So, we're alone again.
Yeah?
Do you want to give me another back massage?
Oh, no, I'm not going to fall for that again, Miss Toots Columbo.
Well, come on, Marvin. How about if I give you a back massage?
Okay, yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Okay, lay down. Hey, Marvin, look up real quick.
What? The news.
Breaking news, okay? The lion that escaped from the zoo has been fed. Since the animal attacked someone, he has been deemed too dangerous to keep alive. He is being euthanized by firing squad tomorrow on Facebook.
Thank God they caught that lion before it hurt someone.
Oh, my eyes are so itchy.
What's wrong, Marvin?
My eyes are itchy.
Oh my God, your eyes are pink.
What, they're pink? Why would they be pink?
I don't know. Maybe you caught something. Call the doctor.
I'm gonna call a doctor.
Hey there, somebody call a very happy doctor.
Why are you so happy?
Because I caught the lion.
You lion.
No, I'm not. Hey, listen here, okay? It was on the news. There was proof. The city paid me to catch that lion, okay? I don't appreciate you calling me a liar because I caught the lion, and it's gonna be executed tomorrow morning by firing squad on pay-per-view. Anyway, what'd you call it?
Because my eyes are pink.
Well, that could be caused by one of two things. Either you've been having some of those special brownies I made, or you get pink.
What's pink eye?
Well, it's when you get shit in your eye.
What?
Yeah, you get some fecal particles in your eye and makes them all red and itchy.
What? Fecal particles?
Yeah, you know, doo-doo.
What? How would doo-doo get in my eye?
Well, I don't know. I guess sometimes when you're wiping your butt, you know, and your finger breaks through the toilet paper, you get some poo-poo on your finger, and then you rub your eye, and you know, you get pink.
Who would do that?
You, apparently.
Well, no, that's not what I did. Could it happen from someone farting in your face?
Yeah, but why would that ever happen?
What if your wife did it to you twice?
What? Oh my God, did she do that?
It was a prank!
Yeah, she farted right in my face.
No. Do you want to press charges?
I would like to, yeah, because she farted right in my face. It was wet and stinky.
It was funny!
If my wife did that to me, they would make a Netflix documentary about what I did. I would kill her.
What, you, listen, how do I fix the pink eye?
Well, I could give you some antibiotic eye drops, but I don't have those on me, so you'd have to go to a pharmacy, like Walgreens, CVS, a Walmart pharmacy, Kmart, that's the whole thing. I don't think they had pharmacies when they were around, so don't go there.
Okay, so what do I do?
Well, just don't let her fart on you again, but definitely get that one down.
Ugh, so itchy.
Sorry.
You gave me pink eye.
I'm sorry!
All right, everyone, my meat is ready. Who wants to taste it?
Ooh, I'll try it.
All right, baby, while you taste his meat, I'm gonna go ask Jeffy if he's hungry, because he hasn't ate anything for dinner.
Okay.
Jeffy, are you hungry? Jeffy? Listen, there's a steak in there if you want to eat some. Okay, mister, for raising your voice at me, now you have to eat green beans. So come on. Baby, I'm gonna go feed Jeffy green beans because he talked back to me. How was Jeffy's meat?
Oh, it was really good. Nice and juicy.
Wait, there's no bite taken out of the steak.
Jeffy's bites again!
Oh, you Jeffy, why I oughta... go feed Jeffy green beans. Jeffy, stop chewing on the table. I got you a big old plate of green beans, so eat up. That is it, mister. You are so proud of. Come on, baby.
I'm sorry, Marvin. It won't ever happen again.
What? No. Jeffy threw his plate of green beans on the ground.
Marvin, he always does that.
Well, I'm sick of it, so you're grounded, Jeffy. And also, I found out that Jeffy has homework.
Oh, but why don't you help him with it, Marvin?
Okay, Jeffy, I'll help you with your homework. Okay. What is the estimate of 3.596 plus 2.4? Anyway, Jeffy, you're the one in school, not me. You're the one that do this homework. So do it. Jeffy! Don't you worry, man!
You might go to jail. Oh my God, my head hurts so bad. Oh, God.
Hey there, somebody call a doctor.
My head!
Hey, you are not going to raise your voice in me, sir, okay? We're going to use our inside voices like adults. Now tell me what happened.
My hand!
Jesus Christ, look at your hand! What happened? Oh my God, has anybody seen his hand?
My son bit my hand.
Wait, your son did that?
Yeah.
That's not your son, that's a lion.
He's just in a lion costume.
Oh, how about that? Wow, that is a really realistic lion costume. Where'd he get it?
Spirit Halloween.
No, he did not get that at a Spirit Halloween. No, if you don't want to tell me, just say so.
Listen, what are we going to do about my head?
Man, that's pretty torn up. You want to press charges?
Yeah, because he didn't even say he was sorry.
Nah.
That looks pretty bad. You might need stitches.
Yeah, it hurts really bad.
Hold on. Hold on. I'm having a flashback here. I just remembered. I didn't wash my hands after I wiped. Ew, I'm gonna get pink eye now.
Well, don't wipe that on me.
Hey, you already have pink eye. What are you kidding?
That's gross.
Wait. Having another thought. Huh. That lion I caught was in your front yard.
You lion.
Bitch, I already told you that it was on the news. There's proof, okay?
What were you talking about?
Damn it, I forgot.
You were saying something. We're trying to remember. Backtrack.
Okay, hold on. Stick your fingers.
You said there's a lion in my front yard.
Yes, the lion I caught was in your front yard, and he could talk.
You lion!
Hey, okay, I'll kill you.
Oh, no, listen, you said a lion could talk? Lions can't talk.
Well, this lion could talk. Hold on, make your lion talk.
Jeffy, say hi. Say what's up. He can't talk.
This lion can't talk, but the lion I caught said he wasn't a lion.
So he wasn't lion?
Huh. Maybe he wasn't lying. Maybe he really wasn't a lion. Maybe I caught your son.
What?
And if I caught your son, then that means...
Uh-oh! What do we do?
I don't know, man. The only lion I ever caught was your son, and he came quietly.
I don't want to die!
Come on, think of something, think of something.
I have an idea.
That is some good catnip. I can see why cats love it so much. Oh, Marvin, look at the lion. He's just lying around. No, he's not a lion. He's a hyen. Because he is suited out of his goddamn mind. Man's is stuck. Oh, man, this is great. We gotta stop doing this to fix our problems.
Wait, I gotta go save Jeffy before he's executed by firing squad tomorrow morning, and I gotta take the lion with me! Hey, wake up, buddy! Come on!
I saved Jeffy just in the nick of time, too. They were about to blow his head off.
Yeah, I felt like I was in Call of Duty.
Good. That's good.
Wait, you guys ain't catnip without me?
Help yourself. Today was a wacky day.
Okay, all right. You know what? That's it. Oh, I'm good. I'm leaving. That was disgusting.
So, guys, what do you want to do today?
We should stay inside and read a book.
Anyone else have any bright ideas?
Well, we could go in the forest and light this firework.
That would be such a cool idea!
Oh, dude, we have to do that. That's fun!
Okay, hold on, guys. It's daytime, so you wouldn't even be able to see it. And also, it's the dry season, so we could cause a forest fire. And the firework is bent, so it won't even fly straight. It might hit somebody.
Cody, are you a firework expert?
No, but I have eyes, and I can see that it's bent.
Then I don't want to hear your opinion if you're not a firework expert. I want to see your firework license.
All right, fine.
Well, we're gonna go light this firework, Cody. You coming?
No, I'm not going.
Wow, stay here and be a loser. Come on, guys.
Loser.
Okay, Jeffy, light the firework.
All right, Junior, this is gonna be sick.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, stay back. Ooh. Stay back.
Oh, dude.
Oh, it hit the tree.
Dude, we just started a forest fire.
Let's get out of here.
Jesus Christ, Simmons, there's a forest fire and there are houses around.
Should we go in the houses and check for cats?
No, I think we should focus on putting out the fire. You go get some bottles of water and start throwing them on there.
On it.
God, I really wish we had a real fire truck with water. We don't really get any funding these days. Okay, I'm gonna call for backup. Hello, Chief? This is Station 4. Thank you. We need backup. Over.
Yes, Lieutenant Guy. What do you need backup for?
Yeah, Chief, I got a forest fire here, and you didn't give me a truck with water, so I don't really know what to do. Also, the Dalmatian you gave me is not a Dalmatian. He's just really cute, and all he wants is cuddles. To be fair, I don't know what the Dalmatian was supposed to do anyway.
Well, what I would do is ask any nearby houses if you can use their water hose. And if that doesn't work, spit on it.
Got it, Chief. Over and out. Thank you.
Hey, man, I found this lighter.
A lighter? That means kids might have been playing with fireworks. Simmons, take that back to the police station and look for fingerprints. Screw this fire. We have a suspect to look for.
Oh, what are we gonna do?
I don't know, dude!
So how did it go? Based on your reaction, I would guess not great.
It went great, Cody.
Yeah, perfectly fine, dude. Shut up.
Yeah, shut your pie hole, Cody.
So how'd it go?
Why do you keep asking questions?
It's SML, God!
Yeah, you're acting like we started a forest fire or something.
We did it.
You're totally innocent.
You know what? I'm gonna turn on the news just to see.
Breaking news, okay? A forest fire is currently burning the forest. The cause is unknown. Please stay away from the area.
Wow, looks like somebody started a forest fire. I wonder who did it.
Dude, they're totally onto us. What are we gonna do?
Ow! Shut up, Joseph. No one knows we caused that forest fire.
Oh yeah, we totally did not cause that forest fire.
Technically, it was the fireworks' fault.
It was the fireworks' fault. It wasn't our fault.
So you guys did start the forest fire.
No, Cody, tell us whose fault this is. We took a firework into the woods and we lit it, and then it blew up randomly and then made the forest catch on fire.
Randomly.
Well, you guys lit the firework, so it's not that random, is it?
Well, we didn't want it to go in the forest. We lit it so it would blow up in the sky. It curved and went into the woods.
It was bent. I told you that was going to happen.
So everyone who buys a firework is supposed to bring you with them to tell them not to do it?
There are warnings on the fireworks.
Well, no one's going to read the warning. They're just excited they have a firework. They just want to hurry up and light it. And we're kids.
I think they just assume it's common sense.
Well, I don't have that.
I know.
So look, I think we should sue the firework company for making fireworks to begin with.
Dude, that's a genius idea.
I think you guys should just stay quiet because nobody knows you started the fire, but if you try to sue somebody, they're going to find out.
Well, no, if we sue them first before we get arrested, then they're gonna get in trouble because we could sue them because why would they even make something that explodes? That's dangerous. And that's stupid. So we should sue them, we'd win, we get more money, then we buy more fireworks, then we cause more forest fires, then we sue them again.
Ooh, the infinite money glitch. Oh, we gotta do it before they patch it.
Yeah, infinite money glitch.
Okay, you guys can just do whatever you want. I'm gonna stay here.
Okay, I'm gonna call a lawyer.
Hey there, you called a lawyer for some legal advice?
Yeah, we did.
Well, I want to let you know that I charge $10,000 a minute, so start talking.
We don't have that kind of money.
Well, then I'm leaving.
Well, no, don't leave. We know your son Richard, and he said that you'd be our lawyer for free.
He said that?
He sure did.
I'm gonna beat his ass. Richard, get your privileged ass in here! Yeah, Dad? You told me to wait in the Lamborghini. Do you know these poor people?
Hey, Richard.
Hi.
I've never seen him a day before in my life. Okay, good. You lied to me.
Well, no, we didn't lie to you. We know him.
Look, here's what's going on. They started a forest fire by lighting some fireworks in the woods, and now they want to sue the fireworks company for making fireworks. Ow!
We didn't start the fire. Someone else did. It was a friend of ours.
A friend of theirs started a forest fire.
I see what's going on here. First of all, you can't sue the firework company. And what I would do is, I would hide, and I wouldn't say anything to anybody. There's your free legal advice.
See, Junior, I told you.
Why would you tell him that we started the forest fire? Now he's gonna go tell the cops.
It was pretty obvious.
No, you should have said our friend caused it. Oh, we're gonna go to jail now. We're so going to jail.
Hey, Susan, can you run the fingerprints on this lighter for me?
All right, let me see.
Trying to figure out who started this forest fire.
Oh my God, it was you!
Oh no! Mike, get in here!
What's up, Simmons? I was putting my cop outfit on.
It was me who started the forest fire!
His fingerprints were on the lighter!
Simmons, how could you?
I don't even remember doing it, Mike! All those poor wild animals!
Simmons, I'm so sorry, but I hate to do this. I have to arrest you.
I understand, Mike. I deserve it!
Wait a second, are you wearing gloves?
No, I am not.
Hold on, there's a second set of fingerprints on here. Enhancing. Bingo! Jeffy, age 18!
Oh, that makes way more sense, Simmons. I was with you the whole time. It couldn't have been you. You should just wear gloves next time. I'm gonna go arrest Jeffy.
Freeze, Jeffy! You're under arrest for starting that forest fire!
See, Cody? I told you that lawyer snitched on us.
Well, nobody snitched, except for his fingers, because we found his fingerprints on the lighter.
Well, if I chew them off, you won't have any proof.
Hey, you can't do that. Spit your fingers out. Stop eating your fingers.
Damn, Poobie, you have a hairy arm.
I sure do.
And it's right up my ass.
Well, Jeffy, have fun in jail.
What, Junior, you and Joseph helped.
Ooh, you dirty cracker!
Yeah, you stupid honky, why would you tell him that?
Oh, we gotta stick together, bro.
Yeah, brothers gotta protect each other.
What, you guys were really just gonna let Jeffy go to jail?
When the pinky gets gangrene, you cut it off to save the body, Cody.
Wait, hold on, you're saying these two kids also started the fire?
Yeah.
Well, no, listen, it was my idea to shoot the firework off in the forest, but I didn't light the firework, he lit it, but I also provided the firework. And Joseph...
I ain't do shit. I'm out!
It's true. He really didn't do much.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I guess you and Jeffy are under arrest, then.
Well, I want to sue the firework company for inventing fireworks.
What? Okay, look, let's just go to jail, and we'll let the judge sort it out.
Yeah, let's let him sort it out.
Order, 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 order. I am Judge Poobah, and today we will be hearing the case of Jeffy and Junior. These two boys are being accused of starting a forest fire and killing chipmunks and squirrels and lizards and lions and tigers and bears. Oh my. You boys, why did you start this forest fire? Did Smokey the Bear teach you nothing?
Well, you see, Your Honor, it wasn't our fault, it was the fireworks' fault.
Yep, it was the fireworks' fault.
Go on, please continue.
See, Your Honor, what happened was we took the firework into the woods and we lit it, and then it flew in the woods and caught on fire. So my argument is that if fireworks were never invented, then that we could have never gotten one, and then it would have never caught the forest on fire. So we want to sue the creator of fireworks.
I see. So you boys are going with the insanity defense. Because, I mean, you must be stupid to think you could sue a firework for blowing up. I mean, that's like me going to a restaurant, ordering food, and choking on it, and then suing the restaurant because I didn't chew my food. That's like me hiring a prostitute and then her giving me herpes and me suing her because she gave me herpes. I mean, I knew the risk, and that's a memory I'm going to have to live with. And my burning urethra. So you two boys are going to have to live with the consequences of your actions the way I live with my herpes. Now, you two are obviously guilty, but what punishment do I give you? Let me just check the punishment book real quick. Oh, there it is! Screw you, forest haters! I sentence you to plant one tree, and I sentence you to one night of community service with police supervision. Officer Guy, you accompany them.
Can't do that, Judge. The Heat game's tonight, so you're gonna have to find someone else.
The Heat?
Oh, you're going to supervise these kids, or you will spend the next month in jail. That's an order. Go Knicks!
Oh, you look like a Knicks fan, you bastard. Come on, kids. Ruining my night. Ugh, I hate you kids for ruining my night.
Hey look, Cody left us a note!
I know you guys are going to jail. Call me when you get out. Love, Cody.
That was nice of him.
Okay, kids, here's the deal. See, you guys are supposed to plant a tree tonight, okay? But fuck that. Mr. Beast already planted like 20 million trees, and I'm pretty sure he's got you guys covered. We're just gonna say one of those trees was yours. Now, you guys are also supposed to do community service tonight, and I'm supposed to watch you. But see, here's the thing. The only thing I'm watching is the Heat! See, because when we win this game, we're gonna go on to the Eastern Conference Finals, and then I get to wear this shirt. See that? Himmy stands for Himmy Butler. See, what he does is he whips out his ball sack on the court, and he rubs it on people's faces while he's dunking on them.
But I thought we were supposed to do community service.
You are doing community service. You're helping a police officer watch the Heat game. Thank you for your service.
But, like, aren't we supposed to, like, tell the community that we're sorry?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. You can tell them they're sorry. Yeah. You can say that by playing the game sorry while I watch the Heat beat this sorry-ass team. Like, who even are the Knicks? You really thought you could beat Jimmy? In your dreams, New York?
But aren't we supposed to pick up trash on the interstate?
What, the only trash that would be on the interstate is if the Knicks' bus broke down on the way home.
Well, like, we can't go pick up trash outside?
What, no, because there's no TV outside and I couldn't watch the Heat game.
Aren't we supposed to, like, go clean up the forest?
Well, okay, you guys can just do whatever the hell you want. Just don't tell the judge, okay? I'm gonna watch the Heat game.
Hey, Junior, wanna go outside and light more fireworks?
Yeah, let's go do it!
Oh, thank God they're gone. Ooh, the game is starting! What?
Breaking news, MK! A second forest fire has started, and this one is so bad that we will have to interrupt the Miami Heat and New York Knicks game with around-the-clock coverage. Sorry if you're trying to watch the game. You won't be able to.
We kinda just started another forest fire.
Yeah, I know! I just saw it on the news! That means I don't get to watch the Heat game! Bam at a bye! No! For anyone who didn't get that, there's a guy on the Miami Heat whose name is Bam Adebayo. You know, Bam Adebayo, Bam Adebayo, it's a pun.
All right, baby, you want to watch a movie?
Sure, Marvin.
Hey, yeah, what did you eat?
Baby, that wasn't me.
I heard it come out of your caboose.
It wasn't me. Look, it was a whoopee cushion.
Well, aren't I just a little stinker? Owie.
Jeffy, why don't you go do something? Like, go read a book.
I can't read.
I have an idea. Jeffy, why don't you go check the mail and see if my shoes came in?
Wait, you ordered shoes?
Yeah, Marvin. I'm sick of walking around barefoot.
Yeah, Jeffy, go check the mail.
Check the mail? My dark home, huh?
We'll take a flashlight, Jeffy.
Oh, yeah, we do have the world's brightest flashlight.
Oh, my God, Jesus Christ! I think I'm blind!
Jeffy,
oh.
Just go check the mail! Marvin, are you okay?
I can't see, I'm blind!
Mail time! Oh, there is a package in there! What is that? I'm gonna go check it out. Hello? Is anyone there? Oh my God!
Easiest murder I'll ever get away with. And the best part is, no witnesses. Oh! Hey, did you see what I just did?
Maybe.
You gonna tell anybody?
No.
Good. Time to get rid of this evidence. You didn't see nothings.
Oh good, the cops are here.
Freeze! Get on the ground, motherfucker! One move and we'll blow you away!
We're not playing around!
Okay.
Hey, drop that lightsaber! I know it's a lightsaber! I've seen Star Wars!
It's a flashlight!
I said drop it, bitch!
Okay!
Okay, Simmons, get him! Thought you could murder a little girl and get away with it, huh? Well, not on my streets!
I found the murder weapon!
Good job, Simmons! Oh, you're going to jail for a long time! Let's go tell your parents what you did! Come on!
Are you okay, Marvin?
No, I have third-degree burns on my face because of how hot that light was, and I can't see.
You'll be okay.
Ugh, your son is under arrest.
Jeffy! Was my package in the mail?
Yes.
Well, did you grab it?
No, I got arrested.
Ugh, I'll get it myself.
Jeffy, why did you get arrested?
Your son killed a little girl. Across the street, no less.
Jeffy did not kill a little girl.
Oh, yeah? Then why did I find him with this lightsaber, huh? Seems like Sith activity to me. Killing younglings.
That's a flashlight.
Okay, Count Dooku. Well, we also found this bloody knife.
Okay, did you find Jeffy holding that knife?
No, but he was very close to it.
Jeffy, did you kill a little girl?
No, but I saw who did it.
Ooh, tea time. Spill the tea. Who was it?
Well, I don't know his name or anything, but he was bald with a little bit of hair on the sides, and he was really scary.
What, was it him?
No, close, but no.
Oh, thank God.
Well, I guess we can take you to the police lineup and you can pick him out. Come on. Okay, Jeffy, these are all the criminals that have been arrested tonight, so just point out which one did it.
Can they see me?
No, you're totally safe in here. This is a two-way mirror, so we can see them, but they can't see us.
Okay, then it was him.
Hey, don't point at me, you little shit!
I think he can see me.
No, he can't see you.
Yes, I can! That little shit in the blue helmet and the yellow Jeffy shirt! You're dead when I get out of here! No air safe for you anymore! No one can protect you!
Yeah, that's definitely him.
Oh, yeah, this is just regular glass. Huh, I guess he can see you. Well, you listen here. Just because this kid right here in this blue helmet and yellow shirt ratted you out and he's gonna make you spend the rest of your life in jail doesn't mean you need to get all mad. You should be mad at yourself for killing that girl.
Well, you just tell him that Noah's safe for him anymore, because I'm gonna send my goons after him.
Nuh-uh. Uh-huh. Nuh-uh. Uh-huh. Nuh-uh. Uh-huh. Nuh-uh. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Nuh-uh. Ha, I got you. I Bugs Bunnied you, so. Come on, Jeffy, let's go.
Good news, sir. We caught the guy that killed that little girl. And Jeffy, here's the one that pointed him out.
Good job, kid. You can have that lollipop.
Okay.
There is just one more thing, though, sir. The killer knows Jeffy's the one that pointed him out, and he said he'd send his goons after him.
Well, you know what that means. He has to go into witness protection.
Okay, great. So where's that?
Your house.
What, my house? Why does it have to be my house?
Because you're a cop. You can protect him and his family.
But, sir, I don't want them to go to my house.
That's an order, guy. Now you tell his family they're moving in with you.
I hate my life. Come on, Jeffy, let's go.
Wee!
I thought you got shoes.
I did, Marvin. They're shoes with wheels on them.
Those are roller skates.
You should get some, too.
Hey there. I have some good news, and I have the worst news I've ever heard in my life.
What's the good news?
Oh, those are sick.
Thanks.
Oh, well, the good news is Jeffy's not under arrest anymore because he correctly identified the killer.
Yay! Wee!
God, that looks so fun.
What's the worst news?
Oh, well, the worst news is now the killer knows who Jeffy is, and he's gonna try to kill him, so now all of you guys have to come live with me.
But why do I have to live with you?
It's like witness protection, where we protect witnesses, apparently by sending them to my house because I'm a cop.
But what if we don't want to live at your house?
Why wouldn't you want to live at my house? It's fun. I have TV. You act like I don't even have TV.
Well, I mean, what if we just want to stay at our house?
No, now you have to live at my house because you offended me. I wouldn't want to live at your stupid house anyway. It's stupid. With your stupid red couch. What are you, like, five, and you're stupid popcorn ceilings. Those are dumb.
Well, how long will we have to live at your house?
I don't know. Just until they execute the guy or whatever. Just come on. So pack up your stuff and we're gonna have a sleepover. We can paint each other's nails and talk about boys. Come on.
Yay!
Okay, welcome to my house. I hope it's not too stinky for you or whatever it is you were expecting. It's not a third world country. We have food. Honey, I'm home. We're home.
Boynie, you didn't tell me we were having company. I would have cleaned.
No, you wouldn't. You never do any of your womanly duties.
Boynie, you're such a cod!
Yeah, well, look, Karen, these people are gonna have to stay here for a little while because they're in witness protection. See, their son witnessed a murder, and now the murderer is after them.
Boynie, that was nice of you to offer for them to stay with us.
Oh, I didn't offer, and apparently they don't even want to be here because apparently they think we live in a barn.
That's because we make animal noises at night, Boynie, right?
She means her snoring. I haven't touched her in years. She snores like a polar bear.
Buddy, there you go again. Always making jokes. It's because I love to drink Coca-Cola.
Yeah. Coca-Cola.
So where do we sleep?
On the couch?
No, Boynie, let them have the bedroom!
What, like hell? That's my bed. They can't sleep in it. It's a sleep number. It's adjusted to my body. It knows what I like.
But Boynie, you said it was only for a little while.
I lied. I don't know how long it's gonna be. They could be here for years.
Boynie, let them have the bed.
All right, listen, where are we gonna sleep at? We're okay with the couch.
On the couch!
No, Boynie, let them have the bedroom! Besides, if we sleep on the couch, then you have to cuddle with
with me!
Ugh. Okay, fine. You guys can have the bed. But don't you dare touch my sleep number. My sleep number is 37, and I'll know if you mess with it.
Okay, baby, I'm gonna put our stuff in the room.
Oh my god! I love your rollerblades! Thank you, I got them today. Boy, I want rollerblades!
You don't even have legs, Karen.
Ooh, boyny, instead of a boob job, I want a leg transplant!
I don't even think they do that.
Hey, can I jump on your back and we can roller skate around the living room? Sure! Whee!
Oh, I have to poop.
The bathroom is right there. Just don't touch my toothbrush.
Oh, man, I only wipe with toothbrushes.
Jesus, this is gonna be a long night.
Breaking news, MK! A man that has killed a little girl has just escaped from jail. He's extremely dangerous, and if you see him, call the police immediately.
Oh no, the killer escaped? Well, that's not good. Well, good thing nobody knows the witnesses are here. Wait, hold on, who's calling me? Hello?
Hey, this is the police chief.
Oh, hey, chief. Are you sick? You sound different.
Oh yeah, real sick.
Oh, well, I'm really sorry to hear that. What can I do for you?
Yes, yeah, so, where are those witnesses against?
Well, I took them back to my house like you told me to, remember?
Oh, yeah, I remember. So, what's your address?
Oh, it's a 321 Pickle Tickle Lane.
Oh, how could I forget that?
Yeah, it's pretty memorable. By the way, Chief, did you see that the killer escaped?
Oh, yeah, damn shame that is. It would be a real shame if they came to your house and killed all of you.
Yeah, that would be really bad. Well, it's a good thing that he doesn't know my address and he doesn't know the witnesses are here, which they are.
Oh, yeah, really good. Well, anyways, I'll see you soon.
Wait, you're coming over, Chief?
No. I mean, like, see you soon, like, tomorrow, at work.
But sir, I requested tomorrow off months ago. You already approved it.
Oh, yeah! How could I forget that? I meant, like, bowling!
Bowling? Well, fuck yeah! I'll go bowling with you, Chief! That sounds like a lot of fun!
Alright, well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, bye! Oh, man, going bowling with the Chief? That sounds great! Maybe I'll get that big promotion. Should I let him win? Oh, I'll definitely let him win. I won't use bumpers.
Hey, we had an accident.
We? What do you mean we?
We pissed the bed.
We pissed the bed? You all pissed the bed?
We were having a tickle fight!
And our bladders were full and we peed.
You pissed in my sleep number, you son of a bitch!
It was a cuddle puddle and it escalated quickly!
Yeah, it escalated into a piss puddle in my sleep number!
I'm done.
Is that mine and Karen's toothbrush in your ass?
Yeah, I told you I had to wipe.
Oh, Jesus, this is a nightmare. I should have let you all get murdered.
Boyne, it was an accident!
In accidents? Plural accidents?
What do we do about the pee?
You clean it! You clean the pee! You take the sheets off the bed and you clean the pee with soap and water!
There were no sheets on the bed when we peed.
Oh good, you peed directly on the mattress? Now it's a piss number! Get the fuck away from me with that! Get the fuck back!
Do we just put newspaper on the pee like in Big
Daddy? Yeah, you put the newspaper on there and sleep in your filth like animals! Jesus, everybody get away from me!
Time to teach that kid a lesson for snitching on me! I'm gonna cut him like a fish!
Oh boy, somebody's at the door! That must be my Uber Eats! I ordered Taco Bell and a Baja Blast!
Time to die!
Hey. Oh my god, that's the killer! The door's locked, idiot! You can't get in, and I have no reason to ever go outside!
Oh yeah? Well, I guess you don't want this Taco Bell, do you?
No! My beefy five-layer burrito! Give me that, you bastard!
All you have to do is open the door and let me kill that kid, and this is all yours!
Well, I can't do that, but I got three people who just pissed in my bed I'm pretty mad at. You can pick from one of them.
No! I want the kid who snitched on me!
Look, I can't let you kill him, no matter how good that Taco Bell is.
Oh, really? Well, I guess you wouldn't mind if I eat this beefy five-layer burrito!
No! Don't do it, you bastard! I'll kill you!
No! That's my burrito, you son of a bitch! No! Spit it out! No! No, don't do that! Don't do that! That's my burrito! No! My burrito!
No! He ate it! The bastard ate it! Have mercy!
Oh, man! That beefy five-layer burrito was so good, but now I'm so damn thirsty! If only there was something for me to drink! Oh, what's that? Is that a Baja Blast? You mind if I get a sip?
Don't you dare sip my Baja Blast! I'll have you beheaded for that!
Here I go!
No! No, my blast! My beautiful Baja Blast! No!
That's it! You can eat my beefy five-layer burrito, but when you drink my Baja Blast, that's where I draw the line! My... My Baja Blast!
Ha! Well, joke's on you! I have HIV, and I have open sores in my mouth!
I don't care. I have my Baja Blast, and the front door is locked, so have fun out there.
That's good. You want some blast?
Sure.
It's got HIV on it.
What?
Yeah, it's got HIV on it. That's what you get for pissing in my bed, you goon.
Ugh. Well, what were you doing at the front door? You were screaming a lot.
Oh, the killer was there.
What, the killer?
Yeah, he escaped. But don't worry, I locked the front door. He can't get in.
What about the back door?
He's the killer!
Marvin, hold my blast. My hands were getting cold. Okay, Marvin, if that killer kills me, do not give him my blast. Even if he has a knife to my wife's throat, do not give him the blast. Got it?
Okay.
Okay, one more sip. No, I can't. Okay. All right, get out of my house.
Are you ready to die?
I said get out of my house.
Not until you give me the boy with the blue helmet.
No.
Is that a Nerf gun?
Yeah, police issue. Never bring a knife to a gunfight. That's for eating my burrito, you piece of shit. We'll never have to worry about him ever again.
Is that a real gun?
Yeah, it just looks like a Nerf gun, so kids will play with it. It's pretty f***ed up. All right, now give me my blast and get the f*** out of my house.
Jeffy, Rose, let's go.